Everyone, welcome to this video. In this video we will be talking about the while loop of the looping of the loops that are used in Java, and under the title or under the topic, the control statements which are used in Java. We have already talked about for loop, and today we will be talking about the next loop which is used, which is the while loop. Okay, so this while loop is as good as the same while loop that we have been using so far, okay, but we will be discussing this as a regular part of your curriculum. All right, so let us begin. So the Java while loop, it is used to iterate a part of the program, okay, iterate a part of the program if the number of iterations are not fixed. So it iterates a part of the program, okay, and this is used if the number of iterations is not fixed. If they are fixed, we can always go for loop, okay. Iterations are not fixed, okay. So and whenever such a situation arises where the number of iterations are not fixed, then it is recommended to use the while loop, okay. And this goes on execution, it executes until the condition which is inside the while loop is false, or the boolean condition is true, until the specified boolean condition is true, okay. It executes until the boolean condition is true. So as soon as it becomes false, it will come out of the loop and automatically the loop stops, okay. So if we have to look at the syntax of the while loop, this is pretty simple, and this will also, you have to recall it from your previous knowledge base, okay. So the main syntax is, so there is the keyword while, okay, while, and there is a condition. Alright, so this is one component of while loop, and after that we will open the braces where we have the code to be executed, okay. It might be a method or it might be a display statement, anything, and then we will have an increment or a decrement statement, okay. Decrement statement which will be going on incrementing the loop or decrementing the loop based on whatever it is specified. All right, so the next thing that we have to discuss is, so this is the syntax basically. So we have a condition and we have the increment or decrement statement along with the code that needs to be executed. Now talking about this condition, so this condition is basically an expression which needs to be tested. It can be a mathematical expression, it can be a logical expression, anything, and this expression, it needs to be tested. So if the condition is true, then this loop body will be executed. Otherwise, the control goes to update the expression, and when the condition becomes false, we will simply execute the while loop. So while loop is no longer there. Now suppose I have to give you an example. So the example of this particular condition can be, let's say I have an variable I which is less than is equal to 50, okay. So while I is less than is equal to 50, so this is the condition against which will be tested for its true value and false value. So until and unless I is less than is equal to 50, that means this loop is going to execute 50 number of times, okay. Otherwise, as soon as it reaches 51, it will be going out of the loop. It will no longer execute. The next one is this update expression, okay. Updating the expression. So what is this updating the expression? So every time the loop body is executed, this expression increments or decrements the loop variable, okay. So suppose here I am using I as the loop variable. Now every time, suppose for I is equal to 1, this loop gets executed once, then I is equal to 2, this gets executed the second time. But how does it increment, how does the value of I increment from 1 to 2? So it is basically increment with the help of this increment operation, okay. So every time a loop is executed, the loop variable is updated. Okay, it might be incremented or it might be decremented based on whatever is the logic of the program. Talking about the flowchart look of this particular while loop, if you have to draw the flowchart of it, we will simply use a condition first. Okay, so just one second. Condition first. So this is the condition. Okay, so this condition, we represent condition using a diamond. So this condition will be checked for its true value or false value. So if it is true, it will go on executing the statement, all right, which is under the while loop, and after that again it will be going back to the condition. All right, it will go back to the condition, right? But before, after the statement is executed, it will simply increment, or let's say, let me keep it as simple, it will be simply updating, update expression. Okay, update expression, and it will go back to the condition. Okay, now if it is false, what happens if it is false? It will come out of the loop. It will no longer execute this loop. Now one thing you have to be sure that, or you have to keep in mind, that in case of while loop, sometimes it might be so that not even once the loop would be executed, not even once. Okay, so what happens is, suppose in the very first scenario, whatever condition I am putting here is false. Okay, now let us consider I is less than is equal to 50. Now if the input variable, or if the loop variable which I am entering here, is 51, okay, so will this condition execute now? No, right? This condition is not true. It is returning me with a false. Okay, and if it is returning me with a false, this statement will no longer be executed. It will simply go out of the loop, right? So this is what you mean by that it might not even execute once. That means if the condition to be tested results into false, like we already saw, the loop body would be skipped and the first statement after the while loop would be executed. Okay, so suppose I have given while, there is a condition and this condition is returning me false. So this entire loop will not be executed. And after this, if I have a system.out.println, let's say end program, so the control will simply be transferred to this point. Okay, this will be printed. This entire loop, it might be 10 lines of code, it might be 1000 lines of code, this will no longer be executed, or not be executed even for once. So this we have to keep in mind. Okay, now suppose, let me show you with an example, or we will look at the example in the next video where we will be doing it. Okay, so before that, we have to look at another concept which is related to while loop, and it is known as infinitive while loop. Okay, so infinitive while loop. So when we are talking about infinity or infinitive while loop, that means it is going to a very, very large number, or it is going to infinity. Okay, so it cannot be counted how many times the loop would be executed. So such a situation also arises in while loop, and this situation arises a while loop when we are passing true in the condition. Okay, so now suppose what I'm trying to do is here, suppose if I'm writing a program, okay, suppose let's say public class test, and then within this I have the main method, which is public static void main string argument s, and then I am writing here the while loop. So when I'm passing a condition which is not which is only true. Okay, when we are passing true as a condition, so if I am writing here system.out.println, it's an infinitive loop. This will be executed until and unless we manually stop it. Okay, so this will be executed until and unless we basically stop it or we manually stop it. Okay, so this passing of true as a condition, that means this condition will always return me with a true. So that means the condition, if I'm testing it several times also, it will give me a true, and that is why the block within this, it always becomes true, or it is always showing me with a true value, okay, true boolean value, and hence this block will be executing till infinity. So these are some of the concepts which are associated with the while loop. Okay, so in my next video we will be looking at this while loop through a program, all right, and that we will try to analyze how infinitive loop also works. Okay, so thank you.